So let's take a look at this water tank problem, where we have a water tank in the shape of a cylinder that's 2 meters in radius and has a height of 4 meters. Water's going into the tank at a rate of 2 meters cubed per minute, and we want to find the rate at which the water level is rising when the water is 3 meters deep. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to identify our variables. The radius of the cylinder is 2 meters, so let's call the radius r, and then we have r is 2. The height of the cylinder is 4 meters, but the height of the cylinder is not really what we're talking about. We're actually concerned with the height of the water. So what we're going to do is discuss the height of the water because that's actually changing. So let's make that a variable and we'll call the height of the water h. Now we want the rate the height of the water is rising when the height of it is 3 meters. So what we want is dh dt when h is equal to 3. Finally, the volume of the water in the tank is increasing at a rate of 2 meters cubed per minute. That was the rate that water was being poured in, so that's going to be our change in volume with respect to time. So we could say dv dt is going to be equal to 2. Now we draw our diagram. So here's our cylinder. And now we need to label our diagram. So let's make this the height of the water. And the height of the water is changing. Anything that's changing, we need to label with a variable. So we're going to call the height of the water h. Now we also have a radius of our cylinder. So let's call the radius r. Now we need to identify which variables are changing and which are not. H is changing because the water level is going to be rising. So h we need to keep as a variable. R, the radius, is not changing in this case because we have a cylinder. So it's always going to be 2. Now if we had a cone, that might be, we'd have a different case. But since it's our cylinder, our radius is not changing. Now what we'd like to do is find a relationship between the height h, which is changing, and the volume v, which is also changing. So the volume of a cylinder is pi r squared h, and so this is going to be the relationship between our variables. So we're going to use that to find the relationship between our rates. So we need to differentiate both sides with respect to time. Now, before we do that, if we have any parts of our equation that are constant, we should plug those values in to simplify a little bit. Well, remember, the r in our problem is constant. It's always going to be 2. So if we plug that in, our formula actually simplifies down to v equals 4 pi h. So differentiating both sides with respect to time, we get dv dt equals 4 pi is just a constant, and the derivative of h with respect to time is dh dt. Now, from before, we had that dv dt was equal to 2. So let's plug that in, and this is the point where we plug in everything we know, and we get down to only missing what we're trying to solve for, dh dt. So our next step is to solve for dh dt. We can do that by dividing by 4 pi on each side, and what we're going to get is that the height is increasing at 0.1592 meters per second, right? So don't forget your units. Now notice in this particular problem, we did not need to use the fact that the water was 3 meters deep. That will come into play in different problems. For instance, if we had a cone, we would need to use that fact. But because what we had was a cylinder, it turns out that the height of the water is rising at the same rate no matter what height the water is at.